Nowadays, everybody seems to be concerned about unboxing the latest phone, the latest tablet, the latest notebook computer, whatever. But me? No. I'm all about that 2005 technology. Hello guys, where are you? David Franco here from DavidTheFranco.com. That is always linked right below. Check it out, I appreciate it. So today's video is a major step back in the history of technology in general, music players, stuff like that. Pokemon Go text, you gotta love it. So today I'm going to unbox a brand new, in the box, never opened, first generation, 512 megabytes iPod Shuffle from 2005. Guys, this thing is over 10 years old. I saw this on eBay, I got it for like maybe $45, I forget. It's been a couple weeks, I've just been busy with other things. So yeah, I mean, I've kind of put this off until after Seaside. But hey, little secret for you, I'm not really in Seaside yet. I'm doing a little bit of a YouTube time travel, if you will. So anyway, this is the first generation iPod Shuffle. I figured I'd buy one on eBay because I own the second generation iPod Shuffle, third generation iPod Shuffle. I don't know about this one. And finally, the fourth generation iPod Shuffle. So again, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. This one was pretty much a breakthrough. I caught it. It had that innovative and intuitive clip design, which just worked. It was beautiful. And on the back, it even says, iDavid. You probably can't read that, but believe me, it's there. Then along came this little guy, the third generation iPod Shuffle. Apple was trying so hard to do something innovative, and I give them complete props for that. It was a bold, bold move back then, because basically, you could only play your music using VoiceOver on your headphones, or perhaps some kind of other way if you found a workaround. Okay, so, but basically you would say, play so-and-so, and it would play it. Hey, it was cool at the time, but realistically speaking, not that useful. So they obviously listened to their customers and they went back to the second generation design for the fourth generation iPod Shuffle, but obviously substantially smaller. And I actually prefer this one over this one because of one main reason. This clip, while it's an impressive design, it's not really that realistic because when you're trying to press the clip, you're pressing the previous button. But with that said, I do give Apple props for making this physically as small as possible without, you know, taking away the physical buttons. So now let's get to the point of this video. Again, brand new first generation iPod Shuffle. Can you tell I'm taking my time because I'm quite excited about this? This literally completes my iPod Shuffle collection in terms of having one from each generation. Now it said brand new in the box on eBay. Unfortunately, it showed up like this. This is broken, the seal. But I'm gonna assume it's brand new, but I have not eBay seller. I'm coming for you. So here we go. In theory, this has been in the box for more than 10 years. Let's open it. And will I be using it? No, I just got it to add to my iShrine, which is right behind the camera. I'll show that in a future video, because it's been a while since I've done an office tour. Here we go. This is a big deal, guys. Back then, I was thinking, what the hell is Apple thinking? There's no screen. But as you probably know, the concept worked beautifully, especially on this. I love this. I took this to college all the time. It worked beautifully. Okay, so in my eyes, this is always like a stick of gum. For some reason, I always thought a stick of gum when I saw this. All right, it looks like it is brand new. Maybe. Let's see. If I can grab the freaking plastic, their packaging has certainly gotten better. Okay, it wasn't sticky, but hey, it's been over 10 years. Again, I'm gonna assume it's brand new. We get some kind of lanyard. Oh, that's right, because you can put it around your neck. Actually, you guys wanna see a really awkward and badly designed iPod Shuffle advertisement I made on DeviantArt? All right, I'll show you. Well, there it is. Yeah, it's pretty bad. Back then, I was obsessed with Apple. And I still am obsessed with Apple, but I don't design things like that nowadays. Let's just say I keep things simple. But anyway, this is the iPod Shuffle little lanyard necklace thingy, because if you want to exercise with this or dance like in their ads. So taking this out, Their packaging has definitely gotten better because there's no easy pull-out tab. There it is. iPod Shuffle. I don't know if this is brand new. I'm gonna have to email the seller. I know, it's been over 10 years. But in theory, this should be perfect. I see a couple dark marks and some hairline scratches. Okay, I'm gonna contact the seller. It's an iPod Shuffle. I didn't buy a freaking Mac Pro, so I'm not gonna send it back, but I will email them and say, look, you said this is brand new. It's not brand new, just saying. But you know what? I'm happy to add this to my collection. Okay, so speaking in terms of the design, I'll stop obsessing over details. You pull off this bottom, boom, and there's a USB plug. You plug it into your computer and you sync your songs, or you can plug it into this, the lanyard or whatever you wanna call it. Put it over your neck and go to town. Nobody dances like that. I know. Calm down. I'm having some fun. So on the back here, this is where things get really interesting. We have the controls. We have a repeat switch and a shuffle switch, hence this being called the iPod Shuffle. And a battery indicator light, it looks like, maybe. Not really sure. Obviously, this hasn't been charged in a very, very long time. But on the top here, we have the headphones jack. And on the very front here, obviously, we have your standard playback controls. Play and pause, volume up, volume down, previous track, next track. And that's it. There's really nothing else to say. My iPod Shuffle collection is now complete. So there you have it. Quick recap. iPod Shuffle, first generation. iPod Shuffle, second generation. My favorite. iPod Shuffle, third generation. No. iPod Shuffle, fourth generation. I think I got this for free. And I think I got this for free. I'm pretty sure I won one of these on Quibids. Maybe it was this one. Maybe it was this one. Maybe it was both. It's been a while. I'm sure I have unboxing videos for all of these iPod Shuffles, of which, by the way, I will link right below. So, to make this more interesting for you, what is your favorite iPod design? For me? Okay, no, hold on, back up. What is your first iPod, but what is your favorite iPod? 1 second. All right, here we go. My first iPod ever was this iPod third generation, back when Apple actually included docks with their iPods. Back then, I was amazed. I honestly didn't even know who Apple was back then. I asked for this for Christmas. I opened it, and I recall just being blown away by the build quality and the fact that these lights, I mean, these little touch-sensitive buttons lit up orange, and you scrolled like this. This was not a click wheel yet. It had the like, little scroll wheel mechanism, but that's the thing. It wasn't really a mechanism until we got this. This is a click wheel. It physically clicks. So this is my first iPod ever, third generation, very shiny. And this is my favorite iPod ever, iPod fifth generation. It was the first iPod to support video playback. And it was my first real interest in video podcasts, which I just thought was incredible. And I'll never forget, Apple used a YouTube music video to advertise this, which I think is pretty cool. It's things like that that will never ever leave my mind. And of course, just like the third generation iPod, the fifth generation iPod, was shiny on the back and a scratch magnet. But this thing back then, 60 gigabytes, was huge. I got this for my birthday and I was just blown away by it. So, first and favorite. You gotta love it. And of course, that's not it. I have a bunch of iPod Nanos behind you. But I don't have any iPod Touches, which is interesting. I've had a couple in the past, but I've sold them. I don't really keep them around. And of course, I have a variety of iPhones. If you guys are ever interested in my iShrine, let me know in the comments right below, and perhaps I'll record an updated collection video. Well, there you have it, David. You talk more than you expected to. What else is new? Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to answer my questions right below. What's your first iPod ever, and your favorite iPod ever? I genuinely am curious. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in my next video. Peace.